Alabama is home to the greatest wealth of freshwater and marine biodiversity in North America. These natural treasures are the state's swamps, rivers, estuaries, and the Gulf itself. In the wake of BP's oil spill, scientists are now researching key indicator species to understand the long-term impacts of the disaster.
An indicator species is a species that is so central to the success and functioning of an ecosystem, that when you lose it, it's a pretty good flag, it's a pretty good signal that you may be losing your whole ecosystem.
Got him. What makes frogs such good indicator species?
They are so dependent on pools of water, being there at the right time to reproduce, and because their skins are very vulnerable to pollutants, it just means that they are a wonderful indicator for how well those wetland systems are working. If we were to lose the frogs, I would worry very much that that was an indicator that something very wrong was going on with the functioning of the delta, and that the delta itself wasn't functioning like it needed to be to protect us and to preserve our water quality.
The Gulf of Mexico is an abundant hunting ground for sharks, and tiger sharks are windows into toxicity passing through the food chain from microscopic organisms to apex species.
The tiger shark is one of those sharks that swims all over the place. So you find them in the near shore areas, you find them in coastal areas, and their diet is really all over the place. They eat seabirds, they eat sea turtles, they eat fish. I mean, anything that you can find in the ocean, the tiger shark takes advantage of. You have an anthropogenic disturbance like that oil spill, and it changes everything because all of a sudden your research has to stray from its original focus, which is the ecology of these important predators, and it has to shift to more of a damage control and a damage assessment. So now I've included in my research questions like, well, how is the oil impacting the distribution and abundance of these sharks? How is the oil impacting what these sharks eat and how that varies across their range? So it's really changed everything. We suspect that these sharks have been in areas that were oiled, or they've been eating fish that were in fact oiled. And ultimately what that means is that that oil is in some way making its way into the upper part of the food web, which is what we're concerned about.
In the worst case scenario, how could this oil spill impact the food chain in the Gulf?
We could see a shift to a completely different and less productive food web. The consequences are dire. Now, I think what this really shows us is how delicate this system is. You know, one mistake, you know, that explosion, we'll be studying the effects of that for years to come.
Aboard the Ocean Alliance, ecotoxicologist John Wise is leading a groundbreaking study into the effects of the oil spill on the whales that migrate through the Gulf. This research on our closest marine relative has the potential to tell us most about how toxins in the water might impact us all over time.
Whales are good indicator species because they're mammals, like humans are mammals, so they represent us in the Gulf. And so what happens to a whale because of an exposure is likely to happen to a human. We're looking for three things. We're looking for petroleum products, which would be from the crude oil. We're looking for chemical dispersants, which comes from the dispersants that were sprayed on the oil. And we're looking for metals because those are byproducts of drilling. We are beginning to believe the dispersants are going to turn out to break DNA. If you damage an adult whale's DNA or a juvenile whale's DNA, you can end up with cancer would be the long-term of possible effect, probably the most dramatic. And if you back up further, you can end up not being able to reproduce or maybe producing a calf that can't really compete in the wild. And so the long-term implications of DNA damage are huge because you could affect the ability of the population to propagate. For me personally, the oil spill made me really realize how bad our ocean pollution policies are and how flawed our thinking is about the ocean. If you think about what happened in the Gulf, we dumped millions and millions of gallons of dispersant from a plane directly on the home of the whales. We would never do that to ourselves. We would never dump dispersants on our yards and houses, but we did it to the whales. I don't want to see us ruining the ocean just because we wanted a little oil.
These scientists may be studying vastly different species, but their work shares one principle. The fate of the animals that live in the Gulf of Mexico's waters will reveal the long-term impacts of our carbon culture's insatiable appetite for cheap oil.
At the end of the day, like the frog in the water or the whale in the water, we as people are totally dependent on water. Most of our body is water. And when we poison the water, we poison ourselves. When we poison our wildlife, we poison ourselves. There's no innocent bystander here. We suffer just as much as they do. It just hits us a little bit later. It hits them very acutely, and we'll get it down the road.
Through the work of Gulf scientists, aquatic species are being studied as the canaries in our underwater coal mines. Their fates will provide indications for human populations as we work to come to terms with how we have poisoned one of the world's most productive bodies of water.